So here it is, of course, would be anticipated that teams would want to start on CT on this map. It is more of an 8-7, in my opinion, map, as the meta's developed.
And by the looks of Cloud9 moved to Sweden. And we're playing.
Oh, this is why they're so much better all of a sudden. This makes perfect sense now.
And obviously, we are now, Cloud9 will not be playing versus. There we go, we got it changed. But yeah, Cloud9 winning the knife round, opting to start on the seat side. Great choice. There's no point in taking a gamble. Cash. Even though it's more even nowadays, you still want to start off on the seat side, especially coming into where you're this late into the group stages.
Well, here we go. Pistol already underway. Already Tech9 coming out for Bondic and for Markolov. Oh, never mind. We are going to get. Are we going to get one more? No, we're not. Okay. It was just delaying its setting to the live phase. So there it is. It's going to be double Tech9. One of them's actually thrown to Hiko, so they're playing the raid boss, the Superman strategy. He's already picked up Kevlar as well.
Yeah, and this is a good choice. Flip side with three smokes, obviously setting up for a smoke round here. Having Hiko on that Tech9 armor, he's the one guy that's going to be doing the rushing here, which is, again, you know, for Hiko, he's most of the times the guy that's last alive. So we'll see if he actually ends up being the first guy in here.
It's cool, too, that they're willing to throw him that gun right away. That says, like, we have enough respect for the guy, even though he's our stand-in, that, like, this guy's got the skill. Why hold him back and just say, no, no, sir, you just do what you're told. No, no, let him play. Let him play his style. So that's what they're going to do. Bondic's going to smoke it over. Look for the A hit. All four players, five now as the bomb joins in, are there and ready to go. Hiko's going to be the one to enter from A main as the door opens. Squeaky needs to be not too exposed. That late smoke came out. He almost got shot in the back. He spots one as he jumps over. It's all Hiko right now coming in. But meanwhile, it's Blade to get the first kill. Nice shot by Shroud as he pops left. Another headshot. Two one-taps from Mike and finally goes down. Hiko's the one to get him. So avenging against his old teammate, it's 2v2. Rotation's coming over. Bomb yet to be planted. It's still not in a position to do so as Hiko has to try and fight off nothing. Hiko actually going to turn back and catch his Sean, so it's all nothing that's left, and the bomb is going to be try and planted right now from Simple, but he might get exposed right now. He has to fake off of it because nothing's in a position to take him, but Hiko's on the other side, and he runs out of bullet. Simple gets the kill. Yeah. Left side, 1-0.
Yeah, and Hiko, with the Tech9 armor, getting two kills there, holding the bomb site. It was getting a little bit worrisome there for flip side after he smoked off the site, and they actually couldn't get into the site. You saw Shroud there, just tapping away, two amazing kills for him, and it was looking very grim, but great round by Flipside, opting to just do a smoke round on A, skipping the armors, and it was a great call. Because you have to keep in mind as well, like Flipside versus Cloud9, if you just look at the players, right, Cloud9 in general have better individual players than Flipside. Flipside, they do have Simple, yeah, sure, Hiko here now being a stand-in, but overall, they should get outmatched here in terms of skill, and then being very tactical versus a team by Cloud9.
A great start by Cloud9 and this Eco as well, as now they've got only one remaining. It's Blade. They took them all down on the way through on the entrance. Bit of a stack on the A and it pays off. They Eco already. Skadoodle closes it out. It's 1-1.
Yeah. Just by trailer thought again, you know, being the lesser skilled team, you want to be more tactical. You saw there as well, just that particular round, it's good to go together when you're on a, when you're on an anti-Eco, but.
Oh, cool effect here where we're like halfway in there. They can see us, our perspective.
I'm getting dizzy right now.
I know. I hope this is like tripping.
Is this how okay, this is how I'm casting now.
Live reactions.
But yeah, in regards to just a regular anti-eco, you don't want to just opt to go towards A because chances are you're going to end up running into a stack.
So already we do see the kill come against Simple. Let's start it off. Cloud9 Skadoodle with the scout. He's going to have Shroud that also has one up on the A site right now. Double scout, Mike looking to go toward the slide. Nope, Mike just look for the jump, get the information. Slow play, but again, they're grouping toward A, so they're going to hit hard here, hopefully get a bomb down, because they didn't do that in the last round even against the Eco. And Shroud, he's playing Ring Around the Rosie, can't hit the one taps this time, does collect the first. Markolov, though, and Blade, they get right back, so flip side looking okay until Skadoodle shows up. He takes down Blade, now they're back, and look at the HP, 20 and 8. Swap to the pistols if you'd like. And it's going to be nothing to find the first with just the nade. That's all he needs to do it. And Bondic's actually going to run. He's got armor and he's got the Tech9. He might as well just try and get away from this. He may switch his angle to mid, actually, and look for an exit. Bombs down inside the
No, he's never going to save this. He needs the money. He needs to die. But obviously, having the time that he has, he can fall back to mid, take out mid, and perhaps maybe catch someone off guard. But there would be no chance that he would end up saving
third round and no bomb down. So it will be AK for nothing. Now, what do they do? Because they've got the scout still on Skadoodle. If they throw it away and go for the op, he's got the money, but he's going to keep it. So he knows that they're going to be saving out one more on T side. No need to upgrade overly soon, and now it's going to be Shroud, actually, who's got the position to build bank with this SMG. Nothing watching the cross. Spotted Simple go over. Just sit back. He knows at least one's there. Hasn't seen the second one come. Nice aid. Well bounced. 2 HP for Simple after that landed. And nothing just pops back out. Easy kill. That's bombed down, by the way. So they have to cross back over. I'm not sure that Jordan will have seen the bomb go down. But either way, they're going to push forward and secure that side of the map. Pico heads out middle. Upside Markolov at least picking up one on Freakazoid. Shroud through mid, catches Eco, gets pushed down by White. Shroud just coming back around, gets tagged up, down to 6 HP. Doesn't actually collect the kill with the SMG, but there's Sean Gares to get it in the end. And now we'll see the guns come out again for Flipside.
Yeah, and it will not be enough money for Simple for an op. Markolov not opting to drop in an op either. But at this point in time where you do have, knowing that Cloud9, they will be saved with Thomas and stuff, going for an AK round here, just trying to get a feel for how Cloud9 plays, and then later on during the round or during the game, opt to buy an op. But in the beginning here, it's good to actually just buy an AK, spread out a little bit, just try and go for picks.
Shroud already pushed up aggressively in mid, looking for some damage through the garage door. Hasn't found anyone just yet. It's more of a passive play this time, now that the guns are out for Flipside. Not looking to group immediately onto the A site. Also have one lurking player. It's actually Simple that's all the way over inside Toxic, or the Sunroom right now, rather. And Shroud falls back. He actually gets himself inside the vents. They're broken from mid's perspective, but not inner. And Skadoodle's playing the same angle. So they could actually, if they push B, have Skadoodle fall quickly with the op after the initial shot, and then tunnel vision onto him, potentially have Mike pop out behind them.
Yeah, having 3 Molotovs on Flipside, chances are there will be an A play here. Just molting off the whole bomb site and smoking it off. It looks to be...
And they could, yeah, there it is. They could Molotov vents to push that player back to B, so it's a longer rotation as well. Give them a better chance to split on A by taking mid. So now head toward it. Freakazoid's still there, spamming through, as is Sean Gares, and Freakazoid's going to get aggressive toward the mouth of the garage. He's got the angle because there's no smoke there, but it's Blade to get the shot. Freak goes down, and Simple taking down Skadoodle. That's the op on the ground. Means that Sean Gares has to hold from the fence, popping back out. It's the FAMAS. They line up. Blade walks right back out on low HP, so Sean Gares collects 2, and now it's Shroud inside mid to fight back and take it away from them. But it's Eco up against Sean. How fitting is this?
He doesn't have any time. Good job by Sean Gares, so running away. It was a little bit slow there from Flipside. Molotov on the bomb site, actually not taking advantage of the fact.
After the round, he's not going to get him.
Yeah, no, but not taking advantage of the fact that he actually molted the bomb site. You want to try and push it as soon as you can, because you know for a fact that it won't be there. Taking it a little bit slow, it worked out well in the beginning. They did get the 2 entries, initial entries, but then Sean with 2 massive kills there on the bomb site, just basically shutting them down. And then by the time that Hiko actually managed to get towards the bomb site, it was way too late.
Sean, I'm actually curious to see if he's going to do the self-smoke where you drop it and pit and play above it and you're not very exposed and it's a really easy angle to spot over top of it. He's done it before. I haven't seen him do it at any lands recently, but he's definitely done it in online matches this season, so... Skadoodle, meanwhile, he's holding over toward A. So they're swapping things around here, actually, because Skadoodle was in mid last round. They brought over Shroud late to try and recover what was lost when he got forced out of the vents. And they're going to go for the boost aggressive play right now as Bondic puts up Simple. Of course it's going to be Simple that looks for this shot. Slow and calculated from Flipside so far.
Yeah, just trying to work with Simple's anti-frag abilities here. Just trying to get the initial pick and then just opt on, okay, what do we do? What do we do here? Who do we end up killing?
Blade wants to go through. Zoid is one of the swing position, but in they go. Blade actually tags up. Nothing. He's down low. But Freak has to come over and help him. When he gets over aggressive on the peak, it works. Somehow Nothing wins that kill. Freak almost overexposed to take down Simple. But he gets caught out in the end. Goes back the other way, and now it's Skadoodle to take the first. Has to fly back through the fire, and as a result, gets Markolov waiting on the outside of the doorway and turns back. Nice reactions as he catches Nothing at the top of highway. Shroud in toward the site. Still a 2-on-2. Low HP. Shroud easily takes down Markolov, and Hiko pops right back out because he's got no choice. 10 seconds left in the round, they get it.
Yeah, Flipside kind of using the same strategy they did the previous round, where they went on middle, trying to split A, not getting the kill on Nothing or Freakazoid. Both were headshotted, both very low, but they managed to stay alive. Coming into the A bomb side, yeah, they got the bomb side, they never got the bomb down though, so you will see Flipside on an Eco, and then obviously Simple. Doesn't really matter if he's on Eco, he's going to buy Deagle anyway, because he is lethal with that weapon.
frequent.
Yep, there we go.
Flash entry, yeah, and simple there it
Dimples
is.
Dimples on.
Called it. So you're calling him on now. Just yeah, one shot with the Deagle.
Yeah, right before, because I know it's going to happen anyway.
So they'll smoke it, re-smoke it, rather, after the fire extinguishes. Gap, though, and Simple, can he get another? He looks, he can't. Sean actually gets back into him. Sean didn't lose very much HP, considering there was two shots rained toward him. It's 57 left for him. So that equalizes back to 4-on-4, and Bondic, he's now going to look toward A, where there's also a slight gap in the smoke, although it's not as big, and he won't have as much information. He does spot Freakazoid jumping off catwalk, so he'll know he's at least inside this site. That's one player spotted. Well, what else can they possibly achieve? And they're going to actually rotate 5-9, bring players all the way over as Skadoodle takes down Hiko. But the bomb's not heading that direction anymore. They still have Bondic inside a main, but here it is. This is the perspective I wanted to see with Blade. He's been kind of watching this B carefully. He'll have heard the first rotation leave, but he may now also hear it come back as Shroud is on the way. Skadoodle, meanwhile, also finding Bondic. 30 seconds again. Even if they want to get a bomb plant down on this eco, they're not going to have the time for it. As Blade with the P250 tries to do what damage he can, but he's down to 10 HP himself. The bomb's dropped, so is he.
Yeah, and for flip side now, you tried for 7 rounds straight now. You need to buy an op-on sample, and that's what's going to happen. You tried out, okay, let's play with the AK first, see how they play, see what we can do with the AKs, and maybe we can play a little bit faster, knowing that, okay, it's not working out for us, guys. We need that op-on sample. We need him to try actually make an impact here, because so far he hasn't really done anything.
So Ska versus Simple, op versus op. Different angles of the map right now, though. Skadoodle's on A, and as we can see from Simple's perspective, he was over towards B, in fact, all the way back toward the spawn, making sure no one's going to push through the tunnels and catch him off guard.
Yeah, it's a very passive play, actually, from Simple, and that's not something that we usually see from him on this map. Normally, you know, you tend to have him boosted in mid, trying to get for the initial pick, or even go towards A, and here we go. So we'll actually potentially see him actually try to get that pick towards A, and if he managed to get that one, A is all open. You just see one rotate coming from Cloud9 towards A bombsite, though.
Short smoke from Bondic, top smoke on top, corner of catwalk thrown as well. So that covers off the left. They'll bounce the one inside the site as well to cover off quad and then rush it. Hiko's going to put out the fire. That'll flush any player back there, and that's Skadoodle. And he's not even in a position really because that flash comes out to fire preemptively through the smoke, and as a result, Markolov's already on top of him. He goes down, and it's all working out for Simple, who enters in on Sean Gares. Finally responds from nothing as he collects two. He may have just spotted the head of Bondic, but he doesn't care. He's going to go get Hiko instead. There's nothing. He wants to get another, but Bondic's there. And now they've got the bomb down. It's all left to Freakazoid. 1-on-3. Low HP for Bondic. 2 kills already going his way. But Freakazoid has to find 1, 2, and 3. Can't react fast enough. Bondic's there.
Yep. Flip side, just starting off very slow, just holding their ground, making sure that Cloud9 does not push. Ending up after, okay, no one's pushing. Let's just do our regular A round. And that's a really good round that they have, because they smoke off everything, Molotov back in sight, boost up on the T-Red, on the bomb site later, and just taking the whole area control. Very nice shot by Simple. You might not think so by the truck, but that was so crucial. If he would have missed that shot, chances are they might have ended up losing that round.
Whoa, not able to connect this time. And this is the same play he played for that we talked about, playing toward T-Spawn to make sure no one pushes and takes the map control. He's not hitting again, and he goes down. That's going to be the type of play that frustrates a guy like Simple. So Cloud9 take the fight. They win the battle on B. They fall back accordingly because they've already got the map and the awareness, but bomb's still up, and they've actually got a trade going back. A refrag from Bondic brings it to 3-on-3 and has a possibility of opening things up entirely because Skadoodle's alone on A. That brings, in fact, Freakazoid all the way back over, but Skadoodle, nice shot as he pops out, finds Markolov in the open door. And so smart, he immediately adjusts his angle, and another one right in front. He can't hit, goes for the no-scope, nails it. Bondic goes down. Hiko has to recover, and Hiko, bomb in his hands, has to plant this. 49 seconds, so he can work this out. In fact, that's what he's going to do. He'll have spotted both players right there as well when he jumps up above. Does he have the courage to try and stick this plant? He will. He's successful. Smoke's gone, though, so he won't be able to fall back to A-Main quite so easily, but he uses it to take the shot, and he gets them both. Hiko! That's the revenge on his old team he's looking for.
Yeah, great clutch by Hiko. Losing that round from flip side, that would have been game over, I feel like. It's Simple missing those three very crucial and easy op shots, helping his teammate. Ended up going down. That's going to hurt. That's going to hurt his self-confidence. Obviously, already coming in from the Cobble game, where he was really not that great either, really not that impactful. So he seems to be in somewhat of a slump now. Maybe it's nerves, maybe not, but hopefully he's going to get warmed up here.
Sometimes when things just don't go your way either, it gets more and more frustrating as Cloud9 push all the way forward, using the pistols to stack up Squeaky, but there's someone waiting on the other side. Bondic He was there for one, Markolov the other three, and Skadoodle's the last that left. He waits at the lockers, and Hiko meets him after class.
Yeah, and in the beginning, I mean, 6-1 in favor of Cloud9 in the beginning. Flipside winning 3 rounds in a row here. So are starting to get a few rounds on the board, so... And we do see here Cloud9. Not that much money, they're still going to buy. Sean Garris opting for the Famas. So he gets the Molotov and the Smoke and a Flashbang as well. And the Skidrule with the Glass Cannon off.
Simple that time, no mistake. As he looks toward mid-kit, Shroud already. Aggressive, though, from Cloud9 again. So we've seen 3 different aggressive rounds. One was an Eco. That's misthrown. Going a little bit too far to the right. Now he has to watch for the fire. But we saw them push B main, win the exchanges. That actually did go back to the 3-on-3. They ended up losing. Like you said, Simple was missing those shots. But Hiko recovers the round. Then they go to the pistols. They push A main. And now they're getting aggressive toward mid. So, again, Sean being very, I guess you could almost say, interactive in his calling, where he's changing it up quite frequently. But nothing actually wins the exchange against Simple. So he only collects one again in this round with the AWP. It was the opening kill, but refragging that, things can slow down a bit for Cloud9.
Yeah, you don't really see Simple actually miss shots like that. He got the initial entry. He had 2 free kills, or freebies in mid, but he ended up missing them as well. So he seems a little bit shaky. Ending up losing the entry. It's still in favor of Flipside, 4v4. And Cloud9 just opted to play very passive right now.
Flash over for Bondic. We saw him run to dodge at Skadoodle. Oh. Realizes actually the door was open to work, but shuts it immediately to slow down the push, and now he's got the shot onto Blade. Skadoodle looks for more, they edge out, he doesn't hit, it's Hiko that gets away with his life, but he's lined up by Freakazoid as all the while they were looking in the corner, he came down behind them from Forklift, and Bondic, he gets dropped, Skadoodle over the top, what a shot. That closes it out for Cloud9.
Yeah, and for Flipside there, they're way too scared of running into the bomb site there. You saw there, Skadoodle actually missed the initial shot. Instead of just rushing him straight off the bat, yeah, you might end up losing one player when you actually rush him, but instead of just trying to strafe and, you know, try maybe hoping that he's going to peek again, it just spends so much time, and it's time that you don't really have, because you're gonna get all of like Cloud9's rotation coming in to help him out, and by that time, it's way too late.
So Shroud inside sandbags, up on top of the hut, as nothing is also in middle, so we'll see if Shroud falls back toward vents as he did in the first couple of rounds. Freakazoid's here as well, so really strong mid presence. And this is what happens when you have someone that's as reliable as Skadoodle to put on A. You can just shuffle players around so much. I mean, you see, in fact, Titan's done this many times with Kenny S. They'll put him up toward quad if he's not hitting the shots toward mid. They'll bring Apex down and help out there with Maniac. I mean, so much dynamics that can be used by that.
Yeah, and especially because you get mid control. You're going to stick 3 guys in mid all the time, knowing that Skadoodle is going to take care of business anyway towards A bomb site and stay alive, which is the most important thing. And then later on when they realize, okay, well, there's no one in mid, they'll just fall back, play it safe, play the positions, play the bomb sites.
So it's Sean again by the fence. Skadoodle's going to play the inside angle to the right of the big red bit crate, but it's nothing already taking down Bondic at mid. Meanwhile, they haven't entered on A. They're waiting for the player in Simple to get in position, but Freak's already spotted him, so he falls back so he's not double exposed and actually wins the duel against Blade, dropping the bomb momentarily. Still a chance that'll be recovered now. Definitely it will, as Markolov and Simple each collect kills. Freakazoid has to hold this. He swings to the first, but he knows they're all coming from every angle. He's not sure if Simple's pushed through mid or not, and good guess as he pops back out just before the smoke, and now Freakazoid one-on-one with Hiko. He's already got 3 kills in the round. Hiko's got the plant down. Hiko gonna break the heart of Freakazoid and Cloud9 fans. He's gonna win the round for Flipside.
Yeah, and it's 2 massive rounds there. One by Hiko in the clutch situation. 1-on-2 and now 1-on-1. Freakazoid doing a very good job staying alive for the whole duration of that round. Getting picked from mid, getting picked from the bomb site. At the end of the day, though, Hiko does come out on top, and he's one of the guys. Again, even on Cobblestone, one of the guys that has been making a difference for Flipside.
Simple again opens up on Shroud. Second time we've seen him get that particular opening pick, and this time it's against Pistols, so they should be able to build on this quite convincingly. Well, we did see a Cloud9 Eco in the second round to start us off, as the pistol was won by Flipside. They're going to go stack up A a little bit here, so a 3-1 split defensively. No one in mid, and a little bit of a push coming through right now from Flipside. As Simple checks vents, pushes down toward Highway. Actually, he's not. I thought for sure he'd smoke and go toward Highway as the rest were looking inside A main, but the bomb's slowly coming back over this direction, so they may just go for B. They may have gotten the read on this. And Cloud9, although they're trying to stack up A with these pistols, they're going to soon realize they aren't going to have the company they were hoping for. In fact, they've all gone back toward B now, and nothing's there, but he's smoked outside the site already. Still being cautious about this. Simple will take down nothing. Bomb to cross and get planted. And how much damage can Cloud9 hope to do when they get back in position to retake? As two are inside middle. Freak coming through. I'm not sure he's even going to want to stick his neck out too soon here. They might just look for positions on either side of the site so that no matter which way they exit, they have a chance at least taking down one player. And that opportunity's already gone. Markolov taking down Freak, so the other two are waiting in mid.
Yeah, just trying to get an exit frag here. You see here that during the later stages of this half, Simple is actually getting more and more activated now. Peeking mid, very aggressive, getting boosted mid, even pushing out mid by himself with an AWP. And that's stuff that we normally see from Simple. We haven't really seen that at the beginning of this half, but he starts to actually get activated now, and he gets these kills. And that's super important for Flipside. If he keeps on going, it's not that many rounds left on the half. Only two, but keeping that up for the last two rounds for Flipside is crucial now. He has a really good spawn towards B here, so he's gonna push B and try and get a picket with his AWP. We might even potentially see maybe a fast B split if he ends up getting the kill.
That's where he's heading. Remember, Flipside started off down 0-7 against Keatstars on Cobblestone and made it back into the round to make it 8-7. It was still in favor of Key, but they got seven rounds in a row to bring it right back, and now we're seeing another situation where they started off a little bit slower as Cloud9 got that eco. And again, it's getting close as we get ready to close out the half, round 14, and a boost, the run boost from Shroud this time. Smoke was out, so they may still actually look to it by default. You can see Maniac, he uses that run boost, but they don't smoke it, so a lot of times he gets completely overlooked. Either way, he's in the corner, and Shroud's another player, but much like Maniac, is a highlight machine when he's in that position. Doesn't matter what gun he has. Yeah, Hiko's already checking the boosted spot to see if they are there.
Yeah. I like the very passive play from Cloud9 in the way of they're actually opted to save one more round. Yeah, buy some pistols and buy the nades, but just save so you actually have that off and all the armor and the nades that you need for the last round. Because obviously, you can still win this.
Shroud's got the B250. Let's see if he can be patient enough if they overlook it, but Hiko, he knows it's Shroud. Shroud's played this spot so many times, Hiko's going to be aware of this, and he knows that they've done it on eco rounds, particularly, and there it is, he spots him already, so aware of his old teammates. Markolov does end up getting the kill as he falls in front of the open doorway. Freakazoid now does at least get a response onto him, but Fondic, it's actually working out. Skadoodle trades it, so Hiko goes down. This is still okay right now for Skadoodle. Doorway's open, he falls back to the hallway. There is one on the inside of the site and two coming forward. As Simple will get the kill, but it's Sean who's got the bomb. This is crucial right now as he picks up the AWP, but he gets flashed out, and Simple gets the kill. If he could have stayed with Vision, had the AWP pre-end, there was a chance.
Yeah, great flash by Bondic there for Simple. It was looking very very grim there. 10 seconds left on the board, and Sean with the bomb. You only have one choice there, and that's the Russian. And Simple's very low. But again, we see here Simple with a very good spawn towards B. Gonna try and do the same initial thing that he did the previous round.
Let's have the AWP for Skadoodle this time. Last round of the first half, 7-7. Who's going to take the slight advantage moving forward as Simple still looking in toward B? And there's no one really peeking out so far. Double, or rather almost triple, as they do now have Freakazoid slide down out of A. So triple presence inside mid right now from Cloud9. Shroud again is the aggressor. We'll see if he falls to vents. It looks like he's already setting up to do so. Nothing again playing by Sandbag. So this is pretty default. And obviously this means Skadoodle's alone inside A site with that AWP, playing it from quad this time.
Yeah, it looks to be the A smoke round once more. And this is a very good play. If they do it really fast now, obviously you will get the rotation from mid. At Cloud9, they do have three guys there, so they will be very fast. But if they do this very fast now with the Molotovs and smokes, they just rush this, then they do have a very good chance of winning this round.
And the Molotov pushes Skadoodle inside the site. They've already got the first kill and flashed out. Blade comes immediately over the top. Now, they didn't Molotov out vents when they went for the A hit this time, so Shroud was able to get in mid right away. That means he's already on the highway, so bomb's down, but he'll have position to cover to see if anyone runs toward A main or even towards Squeaky, but Simple, meanwhile, is going to take down Sean Gares, and it's left to just nothing in Shroud. And so far, Shroud hasn't spotted anyone. Now he does, but perhaps too little too late. They're going to go for it. Where's nothing going to come from? Finally getting the backstab. He's actually in good position right now as Hiko's not looking. He almost lines up too, but good reactions from Markolov. That allows Shroud a bit of an opening to push forward. He still got himself a one-on-two, and he actually guessed correctly, but reacted way too quickly, so Blade will close out the round. They'll win the half, 8-7.
Yeah, very good comeback from Flipside, being 6-1 down. Wasn't looking pretty. It was the same on Cobblestone, where they had a lot of problems in the beginning of the half, and then just ending up working their way back, and even ending up winning this half numbers, Cloud9, and they were looking very solid at the end.
And again, Hiko to clutch out two rounds, one on a one on three, and then another one that came down to a one on one, beat out Freakazoid, who almost had a one on three himself.
Yeah.
Hiko's definitely been an impact player, and that's what he's known for, late round presence.
Yeah. I mean, you can see here, just based, again, I don't necessarily always base it off of that, but look at Hiko, for example. He has 8 frags. 3 of them were basically 2 rounds won from clutching. You do have Markov and also Simple. Simple is, like I was talking about before, he is getting activated now. 15 frags for him. If he can keep this up on the CT side now as well, it's going to be very dangerous for Cloud9.
And speaking of, they look to head toward the A site. There's 3 players in there from the CT side, Bondic being one of them. He's in the corner to dodge flashes. He'll have heard them come through, and he'll have taken down Sean Gears before they even respond. Now he's actually going to use their smoke to his advantage. Very smart as he pushes back, and
oh,
now he's
double.
Got a perfect chance to stab them in the back. Bondic with one. Finally, Nothing takes him down. But the damage has been dealt. The damage has been done, and Nothing is the last that left. This Simple, like you said, coming alive. And in fact, 2 alive for Counter-Strike, apparently.
Yeah, and our game did crash, but we are coming back. Just based off that run, Bondic, extremely smart play, getting the entry, running through the smoke, then running back through the smoke when Cloud9 was running after him through the smoke. I felt like an Inception.
Inception. It was pretty clever.
Yeah,
it was definitely
a smoke,
well
smoke,
played.
Through a smoke. But yeah, very well played. And then the last 2 kills coming in from Simple. Nice headshot. So he, again, if he keeps on playing like this, they're going to run away with this game. Keep in mind, though, Cloud9, they're already through.
And actually, I did look at it when we went sore flip side. They actually took down Boreal.
Okay, so both
they both have 2 wins.
So they're
this
fighting
just
for,
dictates the seed of the group.
They're fighting for the first place spot right now. So even though they're both through, it's either, depending on who you're going to play against, right? So
yeah,
any win a group is still very important.
Which is disappointing for, I mean, this group was, I actually looked at, I think it was group C to be the group of death, but this group actually, in a weird way, one of the big teams comes out. The flip side comes in, they're not quote-unquote big team in Europe, but coming into an event like this, they've got great chances. There's always the factor. Now they've got Hiko, which is playing well for them, working out. Response by Nothing to pick up a double here on this round with the M4. He's actually going to get Blade as well. So Bomb going down leaves Hiko with just the scout.
Yeah, Cloud9 winning yet under the Eco. Nothing potentially might be getting the ace as well here.
And to conclude the point, Joe, just to go back to it really quickly, but Keystar's out again. I mean, that's devastating for them after how much effort they put in this season. But you're right. Let's see if Nothing can close out on Hiko to get the ace. And he's actually heading toward mid to get behind Hiko. But Hiko's running even further away, so I'm not sure he's going to get there in the end. He may. He's heading toward T-spawn. I think he's given up on it. Shroud intuitively to get there themselves. Either way, it's going to be another round for Cloud9. They'll bring this back at least one closer, so 9-8. Flip side, don't extend the lead too much at all. So second time they've won a pistol and then got Nikoed immediately after.
Yeah, Hiko being smart here as well, knowing that he had armor, dropping the scout to Simple, just buying himself a 5-7. There will be a full a 4 spy coming in from flip side, but saving some money on Simple at least. He even bought a C7 full armor, so.
Breaks out the vents himself, but just gets himself in position. In fact, he is waiting for the boost, but that may not happen because the Molotov gets there too soon. And now they've actually Molotoved out vent from the A site. This allows Cloud9 to push forward. Blade's waiting, though, has the pistol ready. Nothing refrags it. Bomb's now just getting ready in A main. They're going to have a duel when they head in because I'm not sure if it's a booster. He's just in the corner based on our perspective, but yeah, it's just in the corner. He's not above on top of the boxes, but they do have someone in the corner immediately on entry. From flip side. In fact, they're going to push through. Bondic again is the man-to-man up, but it's down by Skadoodle. And coming back through, Blade, he gets caught. So Skadoodle holds true with just the pistol out. It's left to Hiko. He's down 9-9. Cloud9 right back in it.
Yeah, only losing 2 men as well, which is great for Cloud9's economy. For flip side, Sam's here sitting on roughly 2K. Need to save here. They can still buy next round, they're not going to have the op on Simple. They won't have all the nades that they want, but at least you will get rifles to try and counter Cloud9.
Free cutting immediately into A main. Bomb's going to join in behind. No one going for a boost just yet. They'll leave the lurk to Sean this time, back over toward B tunnels to make sure no one's going to push through. And they did get the boost into vents this time, so they'll have a mid presence only from vents. But look at the stack they're running right now onto A. They brought 3 players back over from flip side to just hold on to see if they can stop this with the pistols when they try and come in. We saw Cloud9 do this, in fact, on round 2 when this all began.
I mean, when you're full same like this, just even putting only three people, you can put four, even five, because it's a gamble anyway. Knowing that you don't have anything to actually put up a fight with, just stacking five could potentially cause an upset on the round.
Shroud, look at this. Bonix just waiting on the outside of that door, daring him to open it almost. But if they time it correctly, Bonix only going to be able to get one, if that. Because he'll have someone right behind. In fact, Bonix, there it is. He's down to buy Skadoodle as we watch Hiko over on the B site popping out. Might be able to pick up the M4 on recovery right now, having gotten that kill almost for free. But Shroud's over top. He needs to be careful. He did. Okay, he did spot Simple just to his left. Gets the call for Skadoodle to get the shot in. And it leaves Hiko, but again, picking up an M4. So another opportunity for Hiko to just sit back with this rifle and hope the round expires without him being found.
Yeah, saves Flipside some money, and potentially might be able to drop an offer for Simple, because there's a point in time now where you actually end up saving. If the Simple is running off, it does end up going down. But getting the op up on Simple here now, just to try and keep control of the game, is very crucial. Yeah, so actually Hiko actually did drop an off for Simple, which is great. Yeah, Hiko won't have, he's actually playing Glass Cannon with the M4, but just basing off that, just giving Simple that off is so important to the team that it's worth to just sacrifice another player for it.
Simple going for the drop down inside B. Might get there in time, but he missed. This is the shot. Aims a little bit too low, and nothing capitalizes on the opportunity given to him with the AK. They'll Molotov over through the skylight. Skadoodle's already found an entry on Hiko as well. This is working out well for Cloud9 as Skadoodle doubles up. Play to go down. Sean, he heads out on the lurk to go hunting already. As Bondic finds himself alone, at least picks up one kill, but things are not working out at all right now for Flipside.
That round took 25 seconds. 25 seconds coming out of freeze time until Flipside had four guys down, four men down, and bomb down for Cloud9. 25 seconds.
And there it is, a nade to close it out, fitting. The interesting thing that you mentioned was that Simple's on, his numbers are there. But we saw in the first half, too, there was the round that Hiko had to clutch because he missed three shots over at B. That's another one. He misses that opening pick. Now, again, they were rushing him quite heavily with pretty much every man they had.
Yeah.
But they had the confidence to go because he dropped right away. If he stays alive, it's a different situation.
Oh, yeah, yeah, for sure. I mean, even hitting that shot, he's going to make him stay alive. So, again, Simple seemed to be missing the easy shots where he's getting those entries on the T side. But at a game like this, when it's 11-9, you can't afford to miss a shot like that.
Shroud catching out the aggression toward Squeaky. Simple's the second player in his line. But there's nobody standing in his way now. He's killed them both. Sean, again, just sitting lonesome. Now there's three players directly to his left. I'm not sure if he's aware they've pushed up, but he is playing passive. Regardless, he gets his Markolov. Down to seven, though. So he's going to have to be careful when they go for the push. In fact, goes to the reload. That allows Blade to get the kill. But now Blade's alone. I'm hoping for something to come of this, and nothing will. In fact, nothing will come for him. So it's going to be 12 now, Cloud9. They're looking pretty good. You actually talked about after the pistol and the momentum that was shifting, that it could have been flip side. It seems the wind's out of their sails now.
Yeah. Coming into this round, though, just basing off of flip side's name, so this is the first round that they actually have everything. Sure, Simple again. Picking up the AWP, getting the armor, getting one smoke, but then for the remaining flip side players, they have everything. Three Molotovs. Out. Gando, very, very fast round to the B boss side coming in from Cloud9.
Yeah, so they get those B tunnels ultimately very quickly. And in fact, now with the kill from Freakazoid, they can go even further. They're already in the site. Freakazoid doing his job entering, but Markolov's going to drop him. Doesn't matter. The team's following in his footsteps. Not quite so closely, though, so they are still outside the doorways. Shroud, Sean Gares, though, setting up a crossfire from either entry point. We'll take down Markolov and Simple, respectively. One in heaven, one in CT. And now they'll go for the bomb plant. No reason not to, as they've got a two-man advantage. Blade still lurking, trying to get inside the site. In fact, he's going to go with that flash that came through heaven, but nothing catches him before Sean even has to do anything about it. So he can fend for his own. Down to 2 HP, mind you. So as he pushes forward to find Bondic, he will get dropped. But Bondic turning back. Oh, if he had more bullets left in the magazine, a chance for him there. But Sean Gares closes it, and now it's three rounds left for Cloud9 to go 3-0 in the groups and move forward in the top seed.
Yeah, and very smart play. Very smart call from Sean Gares there on that weapon round once more, thinking, okay, we ran B the previous round, and it was so easy. Let's just do it again and see what happens. Doing the same thing, a little bit slower because they didn't get the entry in the beginning when Simple was peaking. Getting Hiko there, you just end up rushing the B boss side, basically, and just put Markolov in a very tough situation to win.
Sean bounced nade into the corner, make sure no one's hanging out where they shouldn't be. Skadoodle going to watch the flank just in case there is an aggressive push right now from the pistols. So they anticipate that this could be an eco based on the fact that they're looking for that already. Simple covering mid. More overview shot to give us exactly the indication of what Flipside is up to, but look at Shroud, wants to Molotov out. Now that bounces, covers off in behind the forklift, and as a result, Blade has to go running. Shroud doesn't shoot at him, though he catches Simple on top of Catwalk. Either way, they're working forward. Bondic responding with one, but Sean over the top, he'll trade it, and has to get refragged by nothing, and it does. This will allow the bomb to go down. Freakazoid taking Markolov. He'd go again, the last one remaining. All the way back over. 5-7 only to work with, and it won't be enough. Cloud9 now, two rounds away.
Yeah, for Flipside's point here now, they have to take a gamble. They have to make a gamble here. Knowing the previous two weapon rounds that they had, they were just very stationed on each respective bomb site. This is the time to actually try something new, try and catch Cloud9 off guard, try and get some more rounds on the board, because this, just playing it safe right now, it's not going to work. Because Cloud9 got you matched.
Let's get a flash himself inside of Squeaky just to make sure he can get around the corner safely, because we've seen them push that actually a few times now. It was Shroud that caught him the first time. Gun Barrel shows out just before the flash does. Therefore, Skadoodle just fires into it, and it's Bondic that pays the price for it. Skadoodle doesn't need to get aggressive now on top of the doorway, because if it gets spammed, he'll just lose unnecessary life points, so he falls all the way back in the hallway. It's my homage to Toby Wan, life points.
Really?
Really.
Just to point out, I have no idea what Bondic did there. He saw the door was open, he just walked past it.
Hyper-focused. Tunnel vision. And Simple sliding out from behind the box quite effectively. Gets the first kill. This allows Blade now to take down nothing. So things, as they slow down from Cloud9, shift back the other way. But Simple, again, not able to hit the shot. Luckily, Markolov makes up for it. But there's Skadoodle to come in. And again, Simple, just those little shots. His scoreline overall as well. But a few more here and there. And this could be an entirely different picture. Shroud now pushing through the smoke. Has to catch out Markolov, but not in time, as Skadoodle does go down. 30 seconds still to work with. Shroud, though, only 5 HP. And that's the equal amount that Hiko himself was missing. So skewed advantage, Hiko wins the round.
Yeah, looking very close, but again, Hiko, even though Shroud only had 5 HP, third clutch round won by Hiko this game alone. And Simple with a very, very crucial kill there in the beginning of the round on the A bomb site, getting that initial kill. Even though he ended up going down after, just getting that initial kill, if they wouldn't have gotten that, because he was actually just about to throw a flash towards the A bomb site as well. And then you would have seen the rush.
Now it's Bondic to wait inside the site solo. They are going to bring a player up now from mid, so an early mid presence this time that we haven't seen out of Flipside quite as much, but oddly enough, Cloud9 not necessarily taking mid quite as heavily as what Flipside did against them on their T side.
Yeah, and the reason why is because you see here that Cloud9 has figured out that we can basically just rush towards the door every single round. You see Shroud doing that every round. Last round it was Skadoodle just rushing the door, opening the door, just looking for picks every single round, and it's been working out for them. They have been getting the picks.
That's what Swag used to do back with Eye by Power. That was his home every single round. Didn't matter if they were going B, he'd lurk there just to hold one player at least back toward the A site. Better off, get the kill like you were saying, but this time a little more of a presence over toward B. Bomb inside the big garage at mid. Actually, Skadoodle that's holding it. We're seeing from his perspective now. He checks every angle just to be sure no one's pushed up while they were absent. But Markolov, Hiko passive in the corner. Markolov's going to be the one to sight. See if Hiko has it. The ability to at least flash for him. He's got two of them. First one's going to be thrown by Markolov directly. Fire out, but he's behind it. That won't allow him to get position to peek aggressively, though, so they'll be able to push all the way underneath heaven initially before Markolov can finally get back out. And now it's Hiko's job to flash over. He does. Markolov re-peeks it. Can't nail the shot, though. He runs out of ammo, so he has to switch to the pistol, and Hiko's gone down in the meantime, as has Simple. So Markolov, running out of bullets and life, will eventually drop down inside the site. Thought was there from Hiko to support him, but unfortunately, it just didn't work out. Now Bondic has to come around from middle. Nothing's going to get in before he can even get outside of the vent, so left to Blade, and this is going to be match point. As bomb's down, they're just waiting for his arrival.
Markolov played it so good on that bomb side. Getting the initial flash first. Everyone was flashed. Ended up missing his ray, getting one more flash. Again, people got flashed. Just not ending up getting the kills, even though the play was really, really good. And you saw there, even Cloud9, they were so low on HP, like all four of them. It was like one more bullet each would have ended their lives.
Yeah, they were so close to being lined up for that M4 as well. When he switched to the USP, it was pretty much all over. They were already on top of the bomb site. So Shroud's gone for the boost. He's up on top of middle. Smoke out on either side of it, as we can see. I don't allow Freak now, based on Shroud's call that no one's home, to walk through the smoke. No need for a flash, no need to waste the utility. Just get the second man inside mid so they can get the presence. But look at this, pistols on match point for Flipside. It's going to be simple with a Deagle. And no one really showing themselves. Really flat strategy. In fact, no one pushing in a main with pistols. No one looking for information. They're just waiting for Cloud9 to show themselves. And eventually Shroud does, but Blade wasn't necessarily ready for that one as he goes down right away. It's simply looking for the Deagle shot. We've seen him do it once already. This game not going to happen twice. It's Freakazoid to take his head off with the AK, and now it's double the advantage, but Bondic gets back at least with one with the P250. Nade goes over. Shroud wants to get up highway, and Markolov's going to make this even more interesting as he takes down Sean Gares. Nothing at least gets back to Bondic, and now they've got A. Bomb's going to get planted over, and the retake has to come from middle as Markolov already out toward highway. Bomb down, smoke off on truck. Hiko gonna reverse that, has an AK picked up, so a bit of a chance here, but look at Skadoodle's position. He's just waiting for him to show himself on the inside of the smoke, but he pops out at the exact moment Skadoodle looks away from it, so a bit of a chance for Hiko, perhaps, to get around the corner, not before Shroud can take down his teammate, so it's all left to Hiko, and he has to clutch it this time. He cannot. Cloud9, 3-0 in group, 16-10 over Flipside.
Yeah, ended up winning the group, and Cloud9's T side, it was awesome. Sean Garris, you know, really impressive in my mind, even the previous weekend in the ESL ESA tournament. You can tell that he's been really working with his men, and they seem to be hitting off quite well. And then coming in from Flipside, obviously, using Hiko as a stand-in, there will be communication issues. Maybe not on the T side, because you basically just have to lurk, right? On the C side, that's when it starts, it starts to get to you, because you actually need to communicate. And say, oh, yeah, I need a flash, help me out here, you know, like everything. But Cloud9, again, very solid, 3-0 in the groups, going to end up topping their group and having